Representative John Boozman is looking to capitalize on what his campaign calls Americans' frustrations with the economy and the out-of-control government spending.
4029's Dave Maloney continues our live team coverage from Little Rock, where Boozman will be watching election results come in tonight. Damon, what's the mood of the campaign?
Well, you know, Angela, this evening and really throughout the entire campaign, Boozman and his staff have had a sense of comfort and optimism. And when you look at those poll numbers, you get a sense of why, for most of the campaign, he has had a sizable lead over Senator Blanche Lincoln.
John Boozman started the day casting his ballot in Northwest Arkansas. The most recent polls by Mason Dixon and the University of Arkansas show, out of likely voters, a double-digit lead over Blanche Lincoln.
Well, at this point, you know, you don't really worry about the polls. You run through the finish line, and that's really what we've done. And so, we've worked hard, and I think right now we're in good shape.
It was back in February when Boozman entered the U.S. Senate race.
And she and I, in many cases, just have very different views as far as the role of government.
In a year when the economy took center stage, Boozman highlighted then and now his opposition to stimulus spending and eventually health care reform supported by Lincoln that eventually became law. Linda Faber fears the country is going too far to the right. She faults conservatives for their criticism over government spending.
I don't like it. I feel that all of a sudden now they're getting concerned about the balanced budget. We've all been concerned about balancing the budget. But how are you balancing it? Whose shoulders is it weighing on?
Terry Dudley says he voted for Boozman. He supports health care reform, but is upset with the way it passed and Lincoln's vote.
And that's a conversation that needed to be held a lot longer in a lot more places and a lot more ideas gotten in place rather than to have it shoved through.
After the results are in, Candy Jones wants to see more cooperation on Capitol Hill.
I would just like to see a more fair and balanced. I would like them to cross those aisles and start working together.
Now, Boozman's watch party is at the Peabody Hotel. This evening, he's keeping a pretty low profile. Earlier in the day, he said while traveling the state talking to Arkansans, they've been talking about the same issues, the economy and creating jobs. He says fixing those issues will require cutting taxes and regulations on small businesses. We're live in Little Rock tonight. Damon Maloney, 4029 News.
Okay, Damon, thank you. Boozman's congressional seat, of course, is open because of his run for the Senate tonight. We'll know if it'll be held by Democrat David Whitaker or Republican Steve Wolf.